Mayor Ross Baraka in Newark absolutely panicked and has made such a bad decision of locking everyone up in their homes. The same decisions being made across this state. We've had Jersey Shore town saying they're going to close the beaches, the boardwalk. This is outrageous, outrageous. And I've said to you many times, and I'll say it again, we are testing more people. That doesn't mean the virus is spreading at the rate of the testing. Let's be clear about that. And I'll give you one more point. Remember this, that when we hear from the experts, whether it's the NIH, whether it's the CDC, et cetera, whether it's the science advisor for the Italian Minister of Health, remember thousands of people who died, many, many, actually, if not most, died with coronavirus, not necessarily from coronavirus. Very important to make that distinction as we go forward. But one mayor in New Jersey standing up and saying, you know what? I've got to do the best thing possible for my local businesses. I've got to do the best thing possible for my my friends and neighbors and citizens in my community who need to get outside, who need to walk around, who need to spend a little money. And you can do this safely on the boardwalk. And that is the mayor of Atlantic City, who's showing some real strength and courage. And he joins me now, Marty Small. How are you, Marty?
Yes, how you doing, Bill? Good morning to your listening audience.
Well, thank you for joining me, and thank you for being available right away. I know producer Kristen reached out to you, and we got you right away, and I really want to thank you for that. Tell me what's behind your decision to leave the Atlantic City Boardwalk open for business.
I mean, Governor Murphy's order was crystal clear. He told everyone to stay at home as much as possible while practicing social distancing. But he also said, and a lot of people didn't get this, that he encourages people to get outside and exercise when they can while practicing social distancing. And the city of Atlantic City's boardwalk is a city street. You know, we want people out there taking walks, getting fresh air. You know, being in the house all the time can, you know, fragile one's psyche. So getting out on our beautiful boardwalk, catching that ocean breeze, just taking a walk or riding your bike can be very therapeutic during a time like this.
And maybe grab some takeout pizza while you're at it, right?
Yes.
Well, I want to thank you, Marty. Let me ask you, how are you holding up? How is the city generally holding up with so many canceled events and closed doors on the casinos? I can only imagine the strain on revenue that it's going to cost you going forward when we finally do open for business over the next, hopefully, week or two.
Yes, I mean, it is, you know, Atlantic City is not immune to what's going on in the world. It's definitely a major economic hit on our community. But Atlantic City is a town of resiliency. We always reinvent ourselves. And as they say, tough times don't last. Tough people do.
You know what? Boy, I couldn't have said that better myself. That's outstanding. Marty, thank you. Thank you for your strength. Thank you for your common sense. Thank you for your courage. You are certainly serving the citizens of Atlantic City well, and I know they appreciate you as much as we do. Have a great rest of your day. Be safe, and you know, check in when things start to reopen. Our lines are open to you anytime you want to talk about how we get New Jerseyans motivated to get to Atlantic City to frequent those businesses so we get you back online fast.
No problem. Thank you for the opportunity.